19, or the Welbeck edition of Red Talk. On this week's show, we're going to talk about the Liverpool win against Liverpool in the FA Cup. Also, we're going to have a look at the Tottenham game preview of the game coming up this week with the Tottenham supporter, Majak. I have a few opinions by him. Not sure if we'll listen, though. Also, a new segment, The Loan Zone, for something a bit different. Also, we'll have a look at a viewer question sent in this week and the oDimitar, one of the biggest segments on the show. It's just huge. Also, we'll take a look at general news with the general and the Chav. Speaking of big segments, that one is absolutely huge. Also, the quiz question, which this week Miles is?
It's Danny Welbeck theme, just like the episode. He's scored 8 goals whilst out on loan, but how many has he scored for United?
I've got no idea. Hopefully we'll find out before the end of the show, so have a think about that one. Manchester United's first FA Cup game of this campaign got underway against arch rivals Liverpool, and one goal in the end from a penalty from Ryan Giggs was enough to go through to the fourth round against Southampton. It wasn't probably not as many goals as we'd hoped, but got through to the fourth round, which is the important thing, Will.
Yeah, we did, and after that first goal, after only a minute, it seemed like we were really going to continue on and push on and really kill the game off, but to Liverpool's credit, they sort of hung in there even after they went down to 10 men. They hung in and they didn't let the scoreline get out of control.
I always thought we were going to score more goals, and there were many times where we had lots of opportunities and we really didn't put them away, which was disappointing. But also, we were talking earlier and during the game about the penalty that got the goal, which was earned by Berbatov. It was not that he dived, but it didn't seem like there was a hell of a lot of contact. Did you think it was a penalty, Miles?
I had to sit on the fence, but I'm not really sure. I think there was probably outside the box, that's maybe a foul. For a penalty, I don't know. It's a big call. There was a little bit of contact, but whether that forced him to fall over or whether he, you know, sort of took a little bit of a dive, I'm not sure. The other thing is, I was talking to Nick about it earlier, if, say, Liverpool had done the same thing, we'd probably be pretty annoyed that that was a penalty. Yeah. So, I don't know. It's a tough one. You know, you might get half those decisions go your way or something like that. So, we were lucky on the day. I think it was good, though, that we held them off, even though obviously they had 10 men. There's sort of the potential for disaster with FA Cup replay. If they equalise, then obviously the next match they go back to a full team. So, you know, we not dodged a bullet there, but it's good. You don't want to be sacrificing and something like that.
And playing an unnecessary extra game.
Yeah, exactly. So we did well.
In terms of the penalty, I thought, when it was given, I thought the ref was going to wave it away, so when he gave it, I was quite surprised. And looking at the replay, you'd probably think maybe 30% of the time actually that would be actually given. So I was pretty happy being a United supporter, but I wouldn't have been annoyed if it was kind of waved away at the same time, especially at that point in the game because it was so early. So, and like you say, if Liverpool had a penalty like that given, he would have been pretty annoyed, which also was one of the reasons that Ryan Babel posted a picture on his Twitter that's got a bit of coverage about Howard Webb in a Manchester United shirt, even though it was from last season, but still a bit of good Photoshop work there. And he's going to have some heat on him from FIFA, apparently.
Yeah, he's going to be a bit of trouble over that one. But I think, back to my opinion on the penalty, I think that he probably... There was contact, definitely. But whether or not it was at the time Berbatov fell over, it was probably a different story. But I know Berber, after the game, came out and said that he did get fouled and he thought it was a penalty. It was, you know, it caused him to lose balance, was one of his reasons that he gave. So I guess we can only take his word. Liverpool fans won't see it that way, but it's a win for us and we're through to the fourth round. So
yeah, well, as I said, I don't really think it was necessarily a... It was definitely not a penalty every time, but I don't think that Berbatov fell over on purpose. Like, you don't think he dived because he's not that type of player, and it's just, you know, you take that one.
Yeah, another positive from the game for me was the performance of Johnny Evans. Now, he started off the season not in the greatest of form, and he's had a bit of a break now from the first team, and he's come back in and shown us what he's made of again. He was very unlucky not to score with a brilliant header from the corner.
Straight into the upright.
Yeah, it's good to see that, you know, we know we've got him and Smalling in case something happens with Ferdinand and Vidic.
Another positive I took out of the game was Steven Gerrard getting sent off in the first half. That was probably the highlight, apart from the penalty to me. But yeah, and if that was one of the reasons Ryan Babel's talking about Howard Webb being, you know, on the payroll from United and all that, I think that's ridiculous, because you can't go in two-footed like that. And Will, you thought it was a red card, didn't you?
Oh, yeah, easily, any day of the week. Gerrard's left the ground, two-footed, studs up. You can't be doing that in the modern game.
Now we're going to preview the game on the weekend at White Hart Lane against those guys there, Spurs. And we welcome to the show for the first time Majak, of course, a Spurs fan. Welcome.
Thank you, Josh. It's nice to be on the show.
No worries at all. Now, United are going to be back to near full strength in this game, Nick. Van der Sar still out with a virus, and Paul Scholes only just come back into training. He'll be out, but apart from that, just about a full team.
Yeah, it looks good. We should hopefully be able to get a good result. Our tactics, of course, are going to play a big role against Spurs, currently, you know, experiencing somewhat of a revolution under Harry Redknapp. Mm. And without Scholes, I think, because Scholes, of course, played that congesting role in the midfield last game, really working hand-in-hand with the right-back, pushing Gareth Bale inside. And I think probably Darren Fletcher's going to be playing that role this time.
Yeah, probably. What about the other two danger men, Van der Vaart and Modric? Maybe sit someone like an Anderson on Modric, who's playing that deep-lying role there.
Someone who's, you know, got more strength on him, because that's what we really need against Modric. And, yeah, that once again comes back to the congesting that we really need to do, stop them passing the ball around, because it's what they're really getting very good at.
Yeah, I think definitely a five in midfield. This game for United. Now, Majak, your boy's going very well at the moment, as it did last season. Champions League beckons again for next term?
I hope so. They've been playing well lately, and I hope they keep that up. Fifth spot is good, but it'll be better if we try and move up a bit in the fourth or third, you know, and keep that spot, really.
And what about the weekend's game? Tough one against the league leaders. Do you fancy your chances?
Yes, I do, actually. We're going in as an underdogs again, like against Arsenal, the last game we played a couple of weeks back. And we won that, so I fancy my chances.
And what about the United team? Who do you see as the real danger men that has to be stopped?
Well, most of the players are pretty good at the moment, but oDimitar's going pretty well at the moment, and he could be a dangerous man at the front. So
coming back to haunt his former club, yes, there, you think maybe?
Yeah, definitely.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah, needs someone good to shut him down. So could be a good role for a couple of backliners there. So.
Yeah, definitely going to be a tough game for both sides, I think. I think both sides are very nervous.
It's going to be very close.
Yeah, indeed. As we said before, United got to really stick with the game plan. I think we went in with last time because it was a very successful one. Gareth Bale, of course, having a superb season this time, isn't he?
He's having an awesome season, I reckon. Including Van der Vaart as well. Them two combinations, you know, him coming from the middle, like in the centre there, and Bale on the wing, and so, you know, they connect pretty well, pretty much. So they control, see Van der Vaart controlling the centre there, which is pretty good for the like strikers at the front, like Pavlyuchenko and that, which is, I reckon he's been playing well so far. And Bale coming from the wing, and should be all right on the weekend. They should go well.
Do we have a predicted scoreline?
Well, I'll start with you, Majak. What do you think?
I reckon it would be 1-0.
Two.
We're going to win.
Okay, I'm going to say 2-1 to United.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with you there, Josh.
Okay, 2-1 it is to United then.
Good luck, boys.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
On to the viewer question now, asked this week by Matt Galea, MG91 at Twitter. Make sure to check out his website as well. The forum, unitedzone.info, and he asks who's going to be the top scorer at the end of the season. Now, if you remember back to a lot of shows ago, we addressed this issue right back at the start of the season, but definitely time for a bit of an update. Now, we've hit the new year 2011. Now, of course, Dimi is the current leader on 15 goals in all comps, followed by Hernandez on 9 and Nani on 7, with your man Will Rooney back on 2 so far. Do you think you can make up the 13 goals difference?
Well, I'd love to say yes, but I don't think he will. I think he'll I think he'll score again. But I'm not sure how many before the end of the season. I'd be happy if he got another 10, 15 goals. Obviously, we want...
I'd be very happy with 10, 15.
obviously, I picked him to score, though. Actually, I think I picked him to take out the top goal scorers this year based on his previous season where he obviously got to 30.
Real talisman.
And... but obviously he's had a few problems with not only injuries but transfers and off the field problems as well, which I think has hampered his goal scoring form. But good to see Dimi banging him away. A lot was like we spoke about before. He was under a bit of pressure coming into this season, and he's really shown that he's worthy of a place in United's starting 11.
Yeah. Now what about you, Nick? Dimi?
I think we've all got to agree that Dimi's going to be pretty hard to catch at this stage, and of course none of us really saw the whole fiasco about Wayne Rooney coming, and we all thought that there'd be a fight between those two for the golden boot at the club, but you know, we've seen a couple of other players step into that mould. We've got Hernandez on 9, I think, and Noni on 7, so it's going to be interesting. Big call here, but I think Rooney could, if he hits form, he could get, you know, over the course of the whole season. I'm not saying he's going to catch Berbatov by any means. It's going to be very hard for him to do that, but I think he can probably get, you know, 14, 15 goals in the season. This would be a very good target for him to hit, considering all the stuff that's going on.
Yeah, and if Rooney does somehow overtake Berbatov, it's obviously going to be a great thing for United, because we're going to be running away with the league if he scores that.
Yeah, exactly.
But what about Dimi? How many do you think he can get to? 15 at the moment?
Well, 15 at the moment, there's a lot of games to go. We're obviously still in the Champions League and the FA Cup. And I think if we go a long way in those competitions, I think we could even see Dimi get to 30. Obviously, he's halfway there now. We're only halfway through the season, so not even halfway. So it's going to be tough. There's a lot of pressure on him to keep that level up. But I think the form he's in, he can certainly do it.
Welcome to a brand new segment on the show. It's called the Loan Zone. First of all, we've got Miles to talk about a few of the players from United who are out on loan. We'll be having a look at a few of the others a bit later, but first of all, Miles. Now, a couple of the players you're going to talk about. Let's know who they are.
Well, the players are Mama Biram Diouf, Tom Cleverley, and Ben Amos.
There you go. Now, let's start with Mama there. How's he going over at Blackburn?
Well, he's been not bad so far. He's played 21 games for the 6 goals, which included a hat-trick in the League Cup. So, and he scored against Arsenal as well. So he's had some good games. He's shown a bit. Whether he's shown enough to be considered sort of potential next season first-teamer, I don't know. Fergie's the only one that can answer that. But he's showing improvement, I think.
Now, a quick question. Do you think he's going to come back to United in the next couple of years, or do you reckon he'll move on or Blackburn will sign him? What do you think his future is?
I don't think it is. I think we've got too many other quality strikers.
Hate to agree, even though I do like the lad. Now, moving on to the next player.
Cleverley, one of my favourites. He's been very good at Wigan, I think. He's just played the 11 games, but 3 goals. He's a midfielder, so it's pretty good tally. One every 3 games, that sort of thing, one every 4 games. So that's pretty good. And with an extended run in the first team, I think he's beginning to show his true abilities. Whether he stays there or not, Fergie's talked about maybe recalling him. Personally, I hope he does, and I'd love to see him play the full season at Wigan, because I think he will get more opportunities there than at United.
Probably don't need to ask you. I think he's definitely got a future at United in the next couple of years. Not going to be snapped up by Wigan nor any other team in the next couple of years. And moving on to the next player.
Yeah, that's Ben Amos. He's at his third loan club, actually, having spent time at Peterborough and Mulder as well. So I think it's quite important for a goalkeeper's education to go out and actually get that game experience. Obviously, it's a lot different playing 90 minutes and concentrating. You might only have 4 or 5 shots to save, but you've got to stay alert the whole game. And so it should be good experience for him. He's only 20. He's represented England at under 18, 19, under 20 level. So he's obviously got a lot of potential. And, you know, he could, if he plays well, gains experience, he's got the potential to be a great keeper for United in his later years.
Let's hope so. Now, get on out of that chair. We'll bring Will in for the next section of the loan zone. Males, and now we've got Will in here to have a look at the next players on the loan zone. Now, who are they?
Yeah, I'm going to be having a look at Danny Welbeck, Kiko Mkhala, who's just gone out, and also Nicky Ojozo.
Why don't you start us off then, Will?
Yeah, well, we'll start with Nicky Ojozo. He's actually gone on loan at Bury, their League 2 side.
Where he's from as well?
Where he's from, yep. So he's played 19 games for them, scored 6 goals, so not moving along too badly.
Pretty good.
Hopefully he shows a bit more and bangs a few more in if he wants to, you know, push for a first team position.
He can probably hope for a loan at a higher up club as well. Yeah.
Secondly, going to be having a look at Kiko Makeda, who's recently just gone out on loan at Sampdoria. He's played the single game and he hasn't scored.
So, bring him back. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. Yeah. No, he's it should do him good, and he was wanting to return to Italy. Obviously, wanting to prove his worth and play for his national team, and Fergie's encouraged that, saying every player should want to play for their national team. But he certainly scored some important goals at United when he's been given an opportunity.
Yeah, he definitely has. The most notable, that one against Villa in the 3-2 win at Old Trafford. He came off the bench and just showed a little bit of his quality and what he can do. So I really think he'll be a player that we'll keep when he comes back. I think he can certainly do a job for us.
I love that term. I think definitely. Probably wouldn't have won the title without that turnaround on the spot goal against Villa.
Yeah, it's definitely a fair point, seeing as we only won by a single point, and a draw would have, and we were behind on goal difference, so yeah, a fair point.
And on to your last player.
My last player is Danny Welbeck, who's out on loan at Sunderland. Little bit of a strange one, I guess, because at Sunderland they've got Asamoah Gyan and also Darren Bent, who, let's face it, are quite good players.
Quality players, yeah.
Proven goal scorers for club and country. Bent probably not, but Gyan certainly is. And he's really gone in there, probably being the third choice striker.
Fair to say.
Yeah, and he's also done really well, similar to the person I just forgot, who he's played at Jose, was it, I think, who played in 19 games and scored 6 goals.
Yeah, I think they probably got him there on loan after losing Kenwyn Jones to Stoke, so they really thought they needed to replace the hole he left in the squad, and he's done a brilliant job for someone of such a young age, and he's definitely getting that loan experience Fergie wanted to get that first team football, and he's going well. Only game since the last show, Dimitar Berbatov earned the penalty in the first minute against Liverpool, which was then converted by Ryan Giggs for a 1-0 win. So didn't score between the last show, but did play an integral part of us finishing off Liverpool. So let's see how we're feeling about Dimitar Berbatov right now.
Dimmy.
Yeah, I think that's about right, Dimmy. You got to fall over when you hack down by some filth. So we'll see how Dimmy's feeling next week.
General and Chav.
Welcome to General News. I'm General News.
And I'm the Chav.
Now, before we start this week, there have been some filthy accusations during the week that my moustache fell off last show.
It's a joke. Who's been saying that? We want to know. Tell us. We'll
get
you.
It was simply editing from Alex. Some fancy stuff they do with the cameras these days. I don't know.
We don't know how he does it.
Anyway, Alex, I know where you live, so watch out, man. Doing that in the future. With some sort of initiation.
Karma, mate. Comes back.
Anyway, onto the news. Of course, Liverpool this week. Kenny Dalglish.
What a battler.
Struggling man.
Didn't even realise he was 1-0 down. He was too busy cheering at the 9,000 Scousers that managed to come along to Old Trafford.
And when he did realise, he did start crying. I definitely saw it.
And he didn't stop till the end of the game.
Yes, exactly. Now, coming into United is going to be one player, says Fergie. One player.
One player, one player only, apparently.
And that could be Lass Diarra, of course.
Big Lass.
The big lass, but he's not a big lass, he's a
had
man.
Had more clubs than haircuts.
He has had many a club, Chelsea and Arsenal included. Still only 25, I think, could be a good signing.
Just looking around off the top four.
Exactly.
Yeah, but the only problem with this is Fergie's been said to want a more creative player in midfield, so we're not really sure what's going to happen.
Jordan Henderson, maybe.
Jordan Henderson, exactly. What a player. What a young player. English love it.
Exactly. Get them young English into that side. Now, speaking of young, but definitely not of English, it's a man whose name sounds like it's a made-up one, but it's not actually...
Paul Pogba.
Exactly. That young lad, he scored an absolute crackerjacker.
Absolute ripper.
A crackerjack lacquer from... many a mile.
Bent like a boomerang, did it.
Exactly. Just a bit of an Australian reference for us Australians here. It bent in, whipping in.
Fergie Charlton and Gill were watching, loving it.
Exactly. First team beckons for the young lad there, the young Frenchman.
Anytime, any day.
Exactly.
Who says you need to buy something? Got in.
And someone's gone out during the week, which not many United fans would have heard of.
Jimmy
Chester has gone to Hull. He's about 75th choice centre-back for the club, and... he was struggling to get in the reserves.
Yeah, so good luck to the lad. Don't blame him.
Good luck to him. Go and get some first team football.
Pity it's a Hull, unfortunate, but whatever.
Pity it's in that city. But
is that a city?
Yeah, it's a city.
I thought it was a landfill, but whatever.
Oh well, okay. Well anyway, that's it for this week from me the general.
And me the Chav.
Back to you, Alex, you manipulator. You better not take off my moustache this week, I tell you what.
Stay on, get on it.
It's now time for the quiz question from earlier in the show, which was males.
Danny Welbeck has scored 8 goals whilst out on loan, but how many has he scored for United?
It's a very good question, and Josh, I believe, has drummed up the answer.
Yes, so far he's scored 5, but I think we'll agree many, many more to come from the young lad.
When he comes back off loan next season, be sure to be banging them in. And hopefully United bang them in before we have our next show on Red Talk. But until then, thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you next time. It's good.